Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel Charts, Chapter 14, Replace Zeros. All right, so I was sitting in one of those staff meetings, right? And the guys from accounting, they're talking about how this fund balance keeps going up and up and up and up. And sure enough, you know, they show here back in 2007, it started around $10,000 and went up through 2008, up through 2009. And, you know, I was kind of a smart aleck about the whole thing. I said, whoa. What happened last month? It looks like someone stole all the money and, you know, ran away to the Bahamas or something like that. And the guy's like, oh, yeah, I couldn't get rid of the zeros. All right, well, all right, this is a common problem. He was getting this data from elsewhere, right? So it was coming from another spot. And because there was no data in the future, those numbers were showing up as zeros, which causes the chart to look as if, you know, basically the fund balance went to zero. So what we want to do here is we want to take the existing formula and say equal if this is equal to zero, then we want to put an NA there. NA. So we're going to use the NA function, NA open paren, close paren. Otherwise, we want the original value. So sheet 1, exclamation H5. Now, if every formula here is pointing at a different spot, different sheet, it's going to be a bit of a hassle to go through and do this, but you see that that changes those values to NAs in the future. And then the beautiful thing about NA is that on a chart, NA is not plotted at all. We don't get any markers, and it, you know, it looks like the fund balance is up there at the very nice 70,000 or so. It doesn't go just crashing down to zero. All right, so if you ever had this where the chart in the future months, there's no data there, so your formula is returning zero, and the chart shows that. See if you can change those future months to NAs to prevent this view. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. I'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.